The next concept in this vector algebra is the product of two vectors. We can define the product of two vectors as like a multiplication of two vector is defined by two ways. Okay, and the first one is which is the scalar product. And the second one is vector product. Now, the scalar product, we can also call it as a dot product it is. And the vector product is called as a cross product. Then what is this dot and a cross product? So, this a scalar product is also called as a dot product. The resultant of the scalar product, you will get the scalar itself. Okay, scalar is nothing but some real value. Then vector product is called as a cross product. The resultant of the vector product is again a vector itself. Vector is nothing but ijk components will be there. In a scalar, only a real number. In a vector product, there will be a ijk component. Okay. So we'll start with a scalar product is nothing but a dot product. Scalar or dot product of two vectors. So I just take it two non-zero vectors, okay, that is A and B. Vector A and vector B, these two are non-zero vectors. The scalar or a dot product is denoted by vector A dot vector B, and it is defined as vector A dot vector B can be written as a magnitude of vector A into magnitude of vector B into cos theta. So this is what the definition for the dot product, and A dot B, which is equal to magnitude of A magnitude of B into cos theta. With the help of this definition, we have a many observations. Okay, I'll just go with the observations. Observation is, the first one is important one, and this is what the basic. So basic observation of a scalar or a dot product is vector A dot vector B is a real number. So there will be a two vectors. Okay, there will be a two vectors. If you do it a dot product, you will get the real number. The second one is, again A and B are two non-zero vectors. I can say that vector A dot vector B is a zero. If the dot product of a two vector is a zero, then if and only if this implies vector A, which is perpendicular to vector B. Okay, important one this is. In the exam, they may ask a question. They will give you two vectors and you need to show that these two are perpendicular to each other. They mention it. Perpendicular is nothing but you need to do it a dot product, where the dot product you should get the zero. Once you will get the dot product is a zero, you can conclude the problem like these two vectors are perpendicular to each other. This is one important observation. Next is, if theta is a zero, okay, in this definition, if theta is a zero, then vector A dot vector B is only a magnitude of vector A into magnitude of vector B. Is it clear? Next, again important one, you should remember this. I'll just take it the ijk component, okay, or three components ijk. If those three are mutually perpendicular, so then I can say that I dot I is also equal with j dot j is equal with k dot k, and this value is 1. So while doing a dot product, you will get two vectors. So while doing that, you need to multiply with the ijk component coefficients only, right? So I dot I there, you will get j dot j, k dot k, that value is 1. That means you need to multiply the coefficient of ijk in both the vectors. Okay? And if I take like a cyclic, okay, that is I dot j, next component, that is equal to j dot k, and this is equal to k dot I. If two different components of a dot product and that value is 0. Okay, same component dot product is 1 and different component dot product is 0. Okay, important one this. And the last observation in this is, that is angle. Angle between two vectors. Fifth one. Angle between vector A and vector B. We can write it as cos theta is equal to vector A dot vector B divided by magnitude of vector A into magnitude of vector B. Also, you can write theta, which is equal to, you can take cos this side and it will be cos inverse of vector A dot vector B divided by magnitude of vector A into magnitude of vector B. So this is what the angle between two vectors. Okay, these are the observation based on the definition of a dot or a scalar product. Okay, based on this observation, we will just solve a few problems. Okay. You just listen to the examples, okay? Because I sent the notes. In that notes, even I wrote in the examples also, okay? You just copy that. And once you copy those examples in the notes, you just watch this video, okay? You will understand those examples. Clear? So, first example, this is, find the angle between find the angle between two vectors A and B with the magnitudes 1 and 2. You make it confused, I'll just write the question. Find the angle between two vectors A and B with magnitudes 1 and 2 and when A dot B is a 1. If you observe the last observation, okay, in a dot product, angle between two vectors, we can write it as the cos theta is equal to A dot B divided by magnitude of A into B. So here all the values is given, is nothing but angle between two vectors, in that vector A and vector B with the magnitudes, okay, which is given. Magnitude is nothing but, I can write magnitude of A is equal to, the first A vector magnitude is 1, next magnitude of a B and that value is a 2. Even the dot product value is also given. Vector A dot vector B, that value is a 1. Okay. Now we just go with the observation. Angle between two vectors, we can write it as cos theta. Cos theta is equal to vector A dot vector B divided by magnitude of vector A into magnitude of vector B. Okay. We just substitute the values now. This is given, A dot B vector is 1 divided by magnitude of vector A is 1, magnitude of vector B is 2, and we can write this is 1 divided by 2. Okay. So here I'll just keep it the theta, and I'll take the cos this side. Cos will be inverse. Cos inverse of 1/2. So cos inverse of 1/2. In which radian it is? 1/2. It is a 60, right? So theta is equal to pi divided by 3. So angle between given two vectors A and B, and this is of pi divided by 3. If it is a negative, what you will do? You will just keep it as it is. If it is a positive, and if there is an a particular value, okay, then you just write it the radian. Okay, write it in a radian always. Don't write it in a degree. Okay, write it in a radian. Therefore, for a given two vectors, the angle between those two vectors is pi divided by 3. Is it clear? So I'll just go with the next one. Again, the question is find the angle find the angle theta between the vectors vector A is I plus j minus k and B is I minus j plus k. Okay, so in the last problem, actually they gave the magnitude as well as the dot product, but here a vector is given. With the help of a given two vectors, you need to find their magnitude as well as a dot product. Once you will get the dot product and their magnitude, then you just go with the definition. Okay, here is, first I just go with the dot product. A dot B is equal to I plus j minus k dot I minus j plus k. Okay, while doing a dot product, you should go with I into I only, not I into j, I into k. You should multiply only I into I, j into j, k into k components only. So here is I dot I, there is no coefficient. What you do is I dot I, then in between here plus and here minus is there, multiply that, plus into minus, minus j dot j, then here is a minus and here is a plus, plus into minus, minus again k dot k. So with the help of the observation, as I said that I dot I, j dot j, k dot k, the value is 1, right? 1 minus 1 minus 1. So plus 1 minus 1 get cancelled, therefore the dot product is minus 1. Now you just go with the magnitude of both the vector. Magnitude is nothing but what? It is the square root of x square, y square, z square. X is nothing but coefficient of I, y is nothing but coefficient of j, and z is nothing but coefficient of k. So in a vector A, coefficient of I is a 1, therefore 1 square. Again j is a 1 square. K is negative 1, so minus 1 square. Now the square root of 1 square is 1, again 1, minus 1 square is, it is a square, so negative will be a positive plus 1. We can write it as 3. Okay, next, magnitude of B is square root of, again the same thing, coefficient of I, j, k, sum of their squares it is. So I is 1 square, j is minus 1 square, k is 1 square. Again you will get the same thing, 1 plus 1 plus 1, and this is of 3. Now you got the value of A dot B and the magnitude of A and magnitude of B. Now you just go with the definition, that is cos theta. We can write it as vector A dot vector B divided by magnitude of vector A and magnitude of vector B. You just substitute the values. So dot product, we got it as minus 1, and this magnitude is the root 3 into root 3, and I just write it, this is minus 1 divided by 3. Hope you guys understood this. How it is 3? So root 3 is there, root 3 all square you will get, and and square and root get cancelled, and this is what the 3. So I can write the angle between these two vectors is, if this is a negative angle, we just write the theta as cos inverse of minus 1 by 3. We just stop it by here only. So this is what the angle between given two vectors A and B. Okay, hope you guys understood this. Okay, we'll do a few more examples in the next class. Okay, thank you guys.